Coaches Show. A lot has happened since the last time we've seen you. We just finished the fall team practice portion. That featured two fall scrimmages, one against Ball State, the other against Valparaiso. One went well, and we walked away with a lot of confidence. One didn't go so well, and we walked away with a clear understanding that we need to defend the baseball and control the baseball if we want to be a good team heading into the spring semester. We had a very good and competitive Fall World Series. There was a lot of drama, the black team versus the gray team. The gray team dominated the entire week of all the little competitions and contests that we had leading up to the three-game series. They also won the first game of the three-game series. The black team, with their backs against the wall, responded really well and won the last two to win the World Series and ultimately win the grand prize of a catered barbecue meal, team meal. We finished the fall team practice portion. We've transitioned into our individual skill instruction time. The coaching staff is focused on developing or individual development as well as some team development, but primarily focused more individually on developing our guys on some of the weaknesses or maybe highlighting strengths on what we saw from the fall team practice portion. Signing period is in the process and finishing up this week. We're really thrilled about our young new recruits coming into the program. It's a smaller class simply because we feel we've built a really solid foundation and we just needed a few pieces to add to what all the good that we got going on here in the program and with our roster right now. It's Thanksgiving week, so from the Purdue Fort Wayne baseball program, we wish everybody a happy Thanksgiving, and I hope you enjoy this interview with Brian Skelton.
Hey, we're here with sophomore pitcher and fifth string shortstop, Brian Skelton. Thanks for coming today, Brian.
You're welcome.
So we got Thanksgiving coming up this week. You're going to go home and see your mom and the rest of your family. What's the one dish that you're most looking forward to having on Thanksgiving?
Probably green bean casserole. Probably my favorite. My grandma makes it all the time.
It's a go-to. Grandmas always make the best green bean casserole. Tell us a little bit about your roommates. Who are you living with and how's that going?
I live with Cade Willard and Spencer Strobel. It's pretty good, you know. I don't really take out the trash, but besides that, they like me pretty much.
Okay, so you don't take out the trash, yet you think that you need a cat at the apartment. Please, let's talk about that.
You know, it's just a friendly guy to come home to, you know. Sit there and pet it a little bit when you get back from class and practice, but, you know, it is what it is.
So, you know, most cats need a friend while you're gone, so are we going to go from one cat to maybe six cats? And are we going to get these cats off the streets, or are you going to do it through a shelter or something?
Shelter, black market, something like that, but, you know, something like that, we can probably figure it out. But, yeah, 1 to 20, we get them up like a quantity, yeah. Keep them in a closet or something.
Probably get a bulk discount, too, if you get more than one.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking about.
Academically, you're a really good student. You do a great job. I've heard that you're kind of carrying a couple of our guys on the team. You're doing a group project with Kate and Sean, and I heard that you're the one really powering through that thing. Do you have anything to say to them about the lack of effort and work that they've been doing?
No, they all did some work. Kay did more work than John. But, you know, all in all, we got the project done, so that's all really
completion,
matters.
That's all that matters. Some people on the team would also consider you the enforcer of the team. Do you do it more out of fear or love? How do you motivate people as an enforcer?
You know, kind of both. You know, they look at my physique, they probably get a little scared when I walk up to them, but out of love, you know, let them know that let's figure it out, but yeah.
I've also heard you're quite the Fortnite guy, that you have, quote, the most skins in the Summit League. How do you pick your skins, and what leads to that?
You know, it's just coolness. How I look when I'm playing, look good, feel good, so how I look at it as, you know, I kind of just, if I like it, I buy it, but.
And then you see it and you're like, don't mind now.
Mm-hmm. Yep, all mine, in my inventory.
Pick it up.
Yep.
Perfect. Well, you came in here, I feel underdressed, you're dressed up really nice today. What's going on? Why are you dressed up so nice?
I was actually going to go grab lunch at the baseball house because Cam told me that Nathan needed me to come help him turn the oven off, so I had to go do that today. But.
Well, you're a good guy, so. Yeah. Well, thanks for coming today.
That was good. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone.